Here at FORM Next, we are in search of the most innovative exhibitors, and I have an appointment with Alexander Spatzik of company NIDAC. Hi, Alexander.
Hello, how are you?
What are you presenting here at FORM Next?
We are presenting our new company under the new leadership of NIDAC Machine Tool. So we are a machine tool company, formerly Mitsubishi Heavy Industries Machine Tool, but since this year we are now under NIDAC Machine Tool, and we are coming from conventional machining, large machines, doing metal cutting. But 5 to 6 years ago, we started to look into new possibilities and therefore developed an additive manufacturing machine and completely process, including the nozzle, the system, monitoring system. Yeah, so, and we want to show the customer what we can do with our machines here at FORM Next.
Sounds great. And we are talking about metallic additive manufacturing, right? It's not polymer.
That's right. It's all metallic, but the various kinds of metals we can do. Yes.
What kinds of materials can you process?
So our material is which we are working on, because we are focusing on the aerospace industry mostly, is titanium, Inconel steels, and just recently we made aluminum alloy part to production grade quality.
Okay. Yeah. Here on your screen we can see three different machine types. Tell me a little bit about it.
So we started with a rather small machine, mostly for the R&D sector, but because we are coming from large machine tools, we thought we have to use this heritage, and therefore we wanted to develop a large machines. So we have up to 2.5 meter parts we can make with our machines, and in order to do that, we had to develop unique systems, because if you're editing titanium, you need usually an atmosphere, and that means the chamber is getting bigger and bigger. You need a lot of time to evacuate and to put the inert gas inside the machine. So we developed a local shield nozzle. That means the atmosphere is always local where we add the material, and then it has time to cool down, so we don't have any problems with oxidization.
So what is the audience reaction regarding those technologies?
Yeah, so actually very positive, very interested. And we have a good example here that shows the capabilities of our machines.
All right.
And maybe we can have a look.
Let's go there. Right.
All right, thank you.
Wow, that is impressive. Is thank that you. Titanium?
Yeah, this rocket is completely made out of titanium in one of our machines. So it's built up. You have a base plate, and then build up layer by layer completely in one of our machines.
But to be very clear, you are not producing those parts. This is just a showcase to have something interesting on your booth, but you are producing the machines to create such objects, right?
Exactly. So our machines are very large, so it's a little bit difficult to bring it here to Frankfurt, unfortunately, maybe next year. But just to show our customers and the audience what we are capable of doing with our machines, we made this sample, and they can have a very close look, have an inspection, or take a photo.
What are the industries you are focusing on with that kind of technology?
So this kind of technology is especially interesting for aerospace industry, and our first customer of these large machines is also in the aerospace industry in Japan, and now used in serial production.
Great. And what are your future plans? What will we see at NIDAC booth in the upcoming year?
So as I just mentioned, of course, we would like to present our machine to the audience. So this is our plan for next year. In order to do that, we have to grow our business here in Europe, and this is the plan what we have with NIDAC. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Alexander, and thank you for watching.